Hello, boys and girls, and welcome to Watch As I Pay. And I decided to monitor, or well, let you monitor my Fallout stuff a little bit more. Start recording from the beginning, but I haven't been doing very much either. So I've just followed the main quest quite to the letter, I think. Start recording from the beginning, but I decided that even though it's not quite my first experience with the old school Fallout, it's still a nice thing to sort of keep an eye on. And the thing that I wanted to mention is that once you've played the first person Fallout game, New Vegas, basically. But oh, come on, guys! Once you've been to the 3D environment, it's sort of fun to come back and check how the computers and everything look in their original shape again. Sort of reflexes towards the buttons, which are not useful. Oh yeah, and speaking of the learning aspect here, I'm quite clueless. Simply can't remember what stuff I had to do in which order so that it would be the most efficient and so on. I do remember there was a water thief involved somewhere, but was it in here or was it Fallout 2? Can't remember. I don't know. have a clue approach is that go everywhere, talk to everybody, try to interact with everything. Wait, can I barter? Nope. Yep. Don't mind me, I'm gonna check out your clean toilet. Operating movement or handling movement isn't sticking to the brain as much as it did after playing the first time, but still after a play session it it still prevails like for a few hours. Do you have any goodies in your toilet? Baby. Okay. So there was another crowbar or something under the bed. Not for the modest! Speaking of music, I was just waiting to hear if the if this theme originally had the typewriter sound in it or not. Sort of, I noticed, some of the ambient sounds, used while doing the test chambers in Big Mountain. Somehow this this theme worked out worked as being very creepy, especially the typewriter part. But at first I couldn't even tell if it was just part of the ambient or part of the music. Okay, save lest I get stuck somewhere. How come the guys always say it's late? Oh, okay. I remember as much that the water thief showed up at night. So if I went now, I could probably catch him, but I don't want to do that yet. I want to hang around. Hang around and observe before. Huh. Before I decide stuff. Hello. right towards the shower. Okay, at this point I have already gotten used to the wall logic here. Again, something that took a little adjusting time at first. But I don't know, I'm still very paranoid at times that I miss stuff just because they are behind some other wall. That you sometimes are able to manipulate is if it's on the other side, then it's very hard to interface with it. To the overseer. Hello, nerds. These are the useful computers, okay. Blocking. Okay, another nerd. us if I'm not going to hoard trophies. And if I'm not going to... science. If I'm not going to hoard the kills, then information is something that I won't pass by. Well, opportunity to get some information about something. Bits and bytes, that's it. Figures. Few computers for the living conditions and the rest for administrative work. Where's the car? I have missed entire rows of lockers due to the wall logic and my forgetting to check on the other side of the wall. Let's see, is there something? Oh yeah. Something here, or if it's just sort of, I don't know, talisman or trophy item or something. Okay, what time is it? Oh, it's actually night time. Oh, okay. That's why the guard isn't here. Oh, then let's hang out. I think. Yeah, some time was passing. Check the computers. Of course, it might be too late for the thief. Let's stop by here. Where's the dog? Stories about the walls where citizens rioted and looted the armory, but this would be after your time. Let's see if the overseer
Have you found the chip?
I don't want to talk about it yet.
Okie dokie, one moment. The chip is initializing. You're safe.
I wanna load. As much as standing here and just sort of hanging around basically made the water thief come out. What if I waited? Sure, this was the guy, but say wait a bit longer. Actually went into the room or something like this, maybe. Oh yeah, okay. Again, nice ass. Hello. Thank you. Oh. Huh? Will turn him into minced meat. Uh-oh. Whoopsie. I'm not sure we're supposed to kill him. In fact, I'm pretty sure we are not supposed to kill him. I think I can remember being able to deal with him without killing him. Direction room. Come on. Wait. I remember that he sort of spilled the beans when I was talking to him. I would say that we are much more suspicious punch than he is. Okay, could say no. Oh, come on. No, you don't. Thank you. Okay, so it appears that a little extra charisma and speech stuff plus stealing saves the day. Okay. First, let's go upstairs and talk to the other folks. The overseer isn't going anywhere. Oh, okay. Late, huh? Yeah, don't just stand there. Everybody in here, please. There's an empty room, so it's just... minutes late. Well, thank you, thank you, thank you. Apparently Dogmeat can run through semi-closed doors. Yes, yes. So, apparently I know this girl. I'm starting to vaguely remember something about something about this floor. It's that after I caught the thief, then some of the citizens became unresponsive or something, or disappeared. I don't know. And speaking of interface, there are just small things. Oh, hello. Small things that start seeming really easy and elementary after you have used them a few times. But at first, sort of first use. What rumors? First use is kind of tough. For example, it took me a while to figure out again how to use the elevator. Because these days you usually get the use prompt or sort of activate button. But just walk in there. guess it's it sort of makes sense too. Different time or different paradigm to remind yourself that that the user interface that's used so widely now, or the I don't know, the choices that seem to be very widespread aren't always the only ones. Things weren't always this way. Check these. In the name of science. What do you mean you can't get there? Looks the dog. Check them all, then I know that there won't be more information to glean. If I don't check them all, then I will always have the nagging doubt that maybe I missed something. Why can they get there, but I can't?
Found the chip? Well, you've certainly earned that right, but let's take care of survival first. Give me the chip and we'll discuss this when you give your report. Okie dokie, one moment, the chip is initializing. There it goes. Self-test is green. Reboot is good. Ha! It's working, and it looks like we have a winner! Oh, you've saved us. You've done it. You saved the vault. You should be proud. But now we need your report. We'll get it from you in the library. Please, go there now.
Okay. Somehow, it seems to me that I don't get the perks often enough. I should have the option that gives you a perk only every 4 levels. That's what I'm talking about. Even in New Vegas, Explorer perks reveals everything in the map. So that's kind of the opposite of an explorer. But if you have a greater chance of finding special shit, then that's what I'm talking about. Useful, but so far I have been able to do without. Let's take this. And I wanted my speech to be up, up, up. Actually, I'm gonna use all this for speech.
I just wanted to let you know that the water supply is stabilized. Actually, we're rebuilding our reserves. You did great. I am a little concerned, however. I don't like your reports. What was in the reports, that is. In fact, they scared the heck out of me. It's those mutants. I've done some calculations and... well, I've come to an unpleasant conclusion. The mutant population is far greater than could be expected by natural growth or mutations. This leads me to believe in... I don't really understand it, but... it looks like someone's generating new mutants. And at a startling rate.
I wonder, does this mean that the time factor... of visiting places and doing stuff. Does it kick in now, after I turn in the chip, or does it sort of run from the game start?
Exactly. And as you've probably guessed, none of these mutations could have occurred naturally, even with the radiation from the war. As long as someone is creating hostile mutants at this rate, the Vault's safety is at stake. Find and destroy this lab as soon as you can.
Okay. All right, so it would seem that turning the chip in early didn't actually do much. I remember getting quite sad endings to my first game because I just spent so much time wandering on the map. But on the other hand, I don't feel like doing all this over again either, so let's just head out there and start doing the next stuff. That the concerned citizen. Oh yeah, the door's closed, okay. Speaking of hoarding and collecting and trophies, it's always sort of confusing when the sequel game has some different item logic. For example, in Fallout 2 there was an abundance of rocks and abundance of junk. Some other stuff that were pretty scarce here, and at first I tried to collect them all. I think I've had. I don't want this. I want this. And I think I have experienced the same stuff with some of the other games. Where the first game. The series has some items that are rare and collectible, basically. Okay. And then in another game, the same stuff is everywhere. Okay, on to the main map. And I think it's time for another break of mine. Make some fresh tea and see if some of those error reports mine have brought some useful information to other people. So, bye bye for now and see you soon. Oh, I have to go to the location to... Okay.